Hey everybody, this is Michael Disser from Click, and I want to spend a few minutes talking about data preparation, or how most people refer to it, data prep. So let's start by talking about that we have raw data here. And this is, again, the data basically untouched, sitting in a number of source repositories. Sometimes this data is pretty hard to understand. You know, it could have column names like XYZ42-3. Very hard to know what we're talking about there. It could have dirty information. It could have basically unstandard information. And what we want is what we call analytics-ready data. So this is something that the user can really understand, easily understand, and make use of. It's clean. It's ready for use. And they could do some analysis on it and hopefully find some new insights in the data. So what's needed between the two here is what we call, figuratively, a data pipeline. Now, what are you doing within this pipeline? You're doing things like perhaps you're filtering the data. You're cleaning the data. There's essentially dirty data. You need to clean it. You're transforming the data. These are just some few examples of what we mean by what's happening in the pipeline, and these are all examples of data prep. So let's take a couple of specific examples. Let's say you have people's ages, and you want to kind of group them or bin them into various categories. So for example, my one group is going to be all the people who have ages between 0 and 9. My next group is 10 to 19, 20 to 29, et cetera. Then let's say I have a field that's just name, but I want to divide that out. I want to split that out into two fields. One's first name and the other's last name. Let's say I have a whole bunch of data points and perhaps these outliers here, I don't want them to affect my calculations. So I want them to be disregarded, so I call them null. Perhaps I'm only looking for data, a particular region, like a particular country. Maybe I'm a product manager who only looks at data for a particular product line. So you may be filtering the information only for a certain type of set of data. These are all examples of data prep. Now, because this is being done really across the board for all the raw data, this is kind of should be an automated process. This could get very sophisticated. So it's probably a data engineer that's doing this work and using some pretty advanced capabilities. But keep in mind, there could also be a need for data prep by the user. So this user over here, perhaps they want to do their own data prep for whatever reason. In this case, this user is probably not very technical, so they're looking for more of a configurable type tool to do data prep. They're both examples of data prep for the enterprise and data prep for the particular user. Okay, so that's data prep. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.